Hey everyone, welcome back to Playcrastination Population 290. Today we're back playing some more of The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus, and the only reason I'm doing so, I will explain in just a second. Hold on. New run. Okay, what did we do last time? Oh, last time we did, we won Greedier Mo with the Keeper, which was awesome. You'll notice the win streak's at 2, though. That's because last night I got back from bowling, and I don't know why, you know? Couple beers deep, you're like, I want to play some Isaac. So I played some Isaac stupidly on this account instead of my other account. Like, I have this other save file that I can play on just for funsies. This is the one where I actually do my recording and stuff. But I was dumb at the time, and so I played on this one, and I played an Isaac hard mode run. And I kind of hate myself, because we got Eden's Blessing on the last run when we broke open the game as the Keeper. And Eden's Blessing gave us Polyphemus on this run, which I'm not sure how that works. I don't know if it's like, no matter who we would have played as next, it would have been Polyphemus. But whatever happened, we didn't end up with... What I'm saying is we don't have Polyphemus anymore. We're going to go for an Azazel Void run today. Try to kill Delirium with Azazel. T7TTHNQE. Now, the only reason I'm playing Isaac... Well, I mean, not only do I love the game, Well, that's a good start. Why do I suck as Azazel all of a sudden? I don't get it. Not only is it a great game, I think that I'm fairly well documented as that being my belief. But, I meant to be recording a new series today. Spoiler alert. I mean, I guess by the time this comes out, the new series will already, like, the episode that I've recorded that I'm waiting currently now to record. There's some, like, weird time skip jump stuff. But basically, it's Borderlands 2. You guys will see that. It's probably already well known on the channel. You know, the HP's not terrible. At the very least, it guarantees that when we get a deal with the devil on the next floor, because we will, let's be honest. Guarantees that when we get a deal with the devil on the next floor, we'll be able to pay red hearts for it instead of paying our spirit hearts, so that's good. But I went to go record today and then realized, again, remember how I said I went bowling last night and maybe had a couple drinks? Yeah, just not in the right head state of mind. I'm stupid. And I forgot to download Borderlands 2, so I'm currently... Please, though, play better with Azazel. It's like I wonder if the issue is that it's so easy that I'm just like, I can play like garbage and be fine, when in actuality, you still have to play decently well, because I mean, HP is a valuable thing. Watch it. Okay. Thank you, game, for rewarding me when I really don't deserve it. I'm trying to make Linkin Park reference here. Watch it tick down till the end of the day, or health slowly slips away. It's so unreal. Gonna lose as Azazel. Watch Monstro. It's Ragman. Still an easy fight. Actually, he's maybe one of the most obnoxious with Azazel, because your range is so bad that if he shoots out those purple tears, you're pretty much done. But he didn't. We're going to get evil safety pin, which is good. The range is so valuable with Azazel. So if we could stack more of those, we'll be Gucci. And, Curse of the Blind. That's unfortunate for sure. But we'll see if we can make this run work for us nonetheless. But yeah, so Borderlands 2, I hope you guys are enjoying it. I think by the time this comes out, I'll probably have already put out like 2 or 3 episodes. Yeah, Black Feather, we don't have a trinket, so why the heck not, basically. I hope you guys are enjoying it. I've never played it before, and I would give you a little bit more Charm of the Vampire, And I'm definitely going to take Rosary Bead for increased Spirit Heart chance, so if you're wondering why, that's why I'm picking it up. I was hoping it'd pay out like right away and make me feel pretty good about myself, but it didn't. We will also visit our shop for sure, because we got 16 cents. Oh, I don't know what I'm buying, but I'm going to buy it. Nightlight, Scared of the Dark. I don't really like this item that much. I don't think it's that fantastic. It's not like some ridiculous coup that we just pulled. So many trinkets. At least we're getting a bunch of choices for trinkets, but unfortunately you can only carry one, so the choice doesn't really help us. Let's fight our boss. It's going to be Pin. That'll be an easy boss fight. We'll get a nice Curse of the Blind deal with the devil, and we will take it no matter what it is. Hopefully, there's only one choice. HP plus luck is good. There are two choices. I will take both of them. I don't know where you are. I was like trying to slow him down with Nightlight. We got the Shovel, and we got Guppy's Tail. So Guppy's Tail, definitely a good pickup. The Shovel, not really. At the very least, it's... You know, gonna lead to the occasional crawl space. We'll get we'll be able to, like, if we go to like the curse room last on the floor, we can save a half spirit heart instead of having to leave. So I guess that's good. It's a free ticket out of boss rush. We don't have to complete the entire thing. So there's a couple benefits that we can possibly gain from this here. I am gonna come in here, and definitely worth it, I would say. We're gonna gain some spirit hearts. I think I'll just pop the Fool card now. Wheel of Fortune will just, like, blow up in here, maybe try to get up to 5 cents. Just short, and we will use the Fool card, and then head on out of here. We're already doing... I feel like Azazel, a regular Azazel run is so much easier than an Azazel Greedier mode run because of things like Tinted Rocks, and like basically I just hemorrhage HP too fast in Greedier mode, so being able to avoid that makes Azazel the character that I respect him for. Well, by respect, I mean, like, he makes it very easy on my life, so... Okay, stand back. Stand back. Let's get rid of that portal. I'm not a huge fan of it. Oh, please. Too many things spawned. Too many things on my screen right now. We also have a pill. Do I want to take said pill? I believe I do. And so we'll take it and get a health upgrade, which is good, because if we can get another deal with the devil, you know, same old song and dance. You know it by now. Hello. Thank you so much. Open that up. We're going to be getting a lot of these, assumedly, because of Guppy's tail. So something like Mom's Key in the shop would be absolutely fantastic to make the chests, you know, on average a little bit more worthwhile. I will open them because if we could find a space bar item like Guppy's head or something, I think personally that would be way more valuable than the shovel. Not that the shovel's a bad item. It's just an item that I don't typically use. So that's an example of a room where we can use the shovel, and that could be like the last of the Mohicans, you know what I'm saying? It could be one of the last, basically the last room on the floor that we do, because we can just like shovel and then go down to the next floor. Now the only risk you run there, I'll pop this, is like when you go to do it and then it accidentally is a crawl space. Like usually you'd be happy that the shovel paid out with a crawl space. It's like the one scenario where you don't want that because it means you can't escape. Not that we're gonna like die in that room anyway. Toothy shot, tough love. I don't know why I call it toothy shot. It's definitely not called that, but, my shiny teeth and me, you know, Chip Skylark. It's pretty good. I don't know if it's like a per tick basis has a chance of having the tough love effect or how exactly it works, but I'm going to go ahead and assume that it does and, basically forget the rest. You're going to blow up. You are going to blow up. And that I should not have gotten hit by that, but I did. And for that, I deserve like a big old spanking, but I don't think there's anybody here to give me one, so at least I hope not. Just check behind me. We're good. Please, though. I'm not bad. I mean, I am bad, but we're better than this at the very least. Silver dollar means that shops appear in the later game. So I think I will go ahead and run with that one. I like silver dollar. I mean, I like rosary bead. But I don't know that it's actually given us any spirit hearts thus far. I also don't even know that's what it does. If we're being completely honest, Hangman is pretty much useless. Let's go ahead and fight our boss. It's Bighorn. You'll notice there, Bighorn got nerfed recently. All the complaining of me because I'm a whiny little, you know what? Basically worked. Please, though. They got rid of his boss armor. They got rid of his whatever you want to call it. People call it. I got to stop walking over that. Whatever you want to call it, they got rid of his damage resistance, which is amazing, because please reserve, like, I get it, but also, like, could we please just reserve that for big bosses, like, you know, Delirium and people like that? We get we get Mom's Coin Purse here, which is okay. I mean, just kidding, I'm excited as garbage. Another health up pill is fine, the bad trip is not. Are you a wizard pill? Doesn't affect us, thankfully. Let's go back and do some exploring. Maybe in the... We can go to the shop. Sure, I'll visit the shop. Even if it's green. Actually, I need to save my keys. Because we want to do that room with all the golden chests. Although, we could find Mom's key in there. You know what? I will waste one key on this room right here. It's not a waste. It could pay out. Stopwatch. Let's buy this first. Two hearts. Useless. 3 cent key we'll take. Stopwatch, you know, could be good for sure, especially against the Delirium fight. Having him go at half speed for the remainder of the thing is valuable. I think I'm just gonna pop this. I'll just do the room. I don't really value the whole. No reason to get all cute with the strategy here. I don't think we have any risk of dying in there is what I'm trying to say. So basically, no reason to get all cutesy with it. I think. I was like, who the heck is still alive? These guys are still kicking over there. But if we can get Broken Ankh, nah. But if we can get the money necessary, I might buy it. I know people really don't like that item, but I think it's pretty good. And on that reason alone, it could be valuable. Where am I going? I'm lost. Okay, let's do this room here. Hopefully we can get some keys out of some of these. Oh, because the more keys that we can get, facilitates, yeah, basically opening all of them, which we can now do, which is good. Excuse me, the I'm excited pill has kicked in, and I was not ready for it. Oh god, this, I can't say for sure, but looking at all the pills, I think I'm excited may be the worst pill in the game. Like, the pill that, I don't know, like, I want to say pill that I like the least, but also the pill that will cause me, personally, to take the most damage. And so for that reason alone, it might be my new least favorite pill. No, we'll stick with Silver Dollar. It's new, and so we'll try to make it work for us. I am going to go buy Stopwatch now. I know we're kind of slowing down. We do have to make sure we make that Hush fight, but it's pretty easy with Azazel to go at a speed that allows for that. So I'm going to blow up our donation machine and go ahead and buy the Stopwatch. Just for future benefits, basically. It can help us out later, and then we'll go ahead and hop down to the next floor, carrying our Silver Dollar. Is that really the trinket we want? I mean, too late to redecide now, so we'll just have to assume yes. How do I think this run is going so far? I mean, we haven't gotten anything, like, damage. I mean, I guess if Tough Love works the way that I hope it does, then I guess you can call that a damage upgrade. But beyond that, we haven't really received that many damage upgrades, meaning zero. And so, you know, basically we're just still first floor Azazel, but luckily first floor Azazel is more powerful than, like, fifth floor most characters. Oh my god, I didn't even see him. And for that reason alone, thank you for the Balls of Steel. Oh no, I have castrated myself by not holding onto a key. So we'd like to find another key, or a key, I should say, just one. Will help out a ton. Addicted's bad. One makes you small is okay. Why does my face look like that? I don't know. Does your face always do that with Brimstone? I guess it does. It's just because the addicted pill, it was making it a different color. I'm guessing secret room here, which means we can get into our shop, but now we don't, I mean, we still can if we want to. Might as well pop these, look for that crawl space not existing. We'll see what the shop has. I'm actually hoping for greed so that we can get some money, and we do get greed for the first time ever. The man shows himself. Ooh, that must have been an electric charged key because it filled up our shovel. Scorpius Vine, it's okay. It's at least a kind of a passive damage upgrade, if you will, damage over time. In here, we will pick up Contract from Below, which is a fantastic item. And that'll, I think that will really incentivize having this, Silver Dollar for later, because you would imagine with double payouts, you're going to be stacking up money a lot quicker than before. So, actually, we already found the secret room, so that was dumb. But you would imagine we're going to be stacking up money a lot quicker than we typically would. So, hopefully, we'll have money later in the game to do stuff with. Any of these health down? Not really interested. Verp gives you the same last pill you just had, and then we had a Balls of Steel. So, now that we know that it's a Verp pill, and actually, this sounds stupid. Okay, here's what we should do. We should do the deal with the devil first. We should, hopefully, I mean, we only have a 70% chance, but we should attempt to get a deal with the devil first, and then take an item on the deal with the devil that can drop us down to 1 or 0 HP, and then we can use the health down as a health upgrade, but I also want to get into that, the little boss fight room to just to see what's in there. We might not even do it, but just the knowledge of what the heck is going on in there, I think, is pretty valuable. So we can, once we go down to 1 HP, and if we don't get a deal with the devil, I'm just going to use the health down pill, although that sounds dumb, to see what's in there. Again, it sounds kind of dumb, but that's what I'm going to do. I've already decided. You're not talking me out of it. I hear you trying to talk me out of it right now. I mean, maybe you're not. Maybe you're like, that's pretty smart. Maybe. But it's all going to depend on if we do not get this deal with the devil. Obviously, best case scenario, we just get the deal with the devil because the game is kind and we can appreciate it from there. Thank you. Please stand back. Please stand back. Second secret room here, maybe. That's not even where you would place that, you dummy, but it worked. And we get a pretty good, one of my favorite secret rooms for sure, of the second variety, that is, or super secret rooms if we want to be technically correct about it. Ooh, Head of the Keeper doesn't work with Brimstone. Maybe. Cannot remember. Honestly cannot recall at this current moment. And let's go for like Cricket's Head in here. No doing, but the money and the consumables are very nice. So let's Go and fight the Wretched. Shouldn't be that difficult. Even with base Azazel damage, which we're still rocking, unfortunately. But, you know, this could be the turn. This could be where the worm turns, as they say. We don't get the deal with the devil, but we do get squeezy. So I'm going to do exactly what I said I was going to do. I'm a man of my word. We're going to health down. We're going to lose an HP for basically no reason. Just so that I can come into the mob trap room or the whatever it's called. I don't know the technical terms for any of this stuff. But so that we can go into this room and see if it's worth doing. Basically, if it's gold or red chests, I'll do it. It is gold chests. We get Sack of Sacks, which I think is a great item. It's better in greedier mode, but I think it'll also be... I don't know that it's better in greedier mode. It just has a higher chance of... I'm pretty much just saying that after the keep run because Sack of Sacks gave us... Blood Bag basically gives us that HP we forfeited right back. So basically we just got Sack of Sacks for free. And then do we want... Ow. Do we want this Locust? I can't remember what all the Locusts do. So I can't remember if this is a good Locust or not. I mean, I think all the Locusts are decent. But I still want to stick with this Later Shops thing. Although we don't really, like, get that much value from Later Shops. I'm going to pick it up just in case I have it. Locust of Conquest. I'm almost 100% sure we've picked that up before. And now we can go ahead and head down to the next floor. A little bit behind, maybe a little slower than where I'd like to be, but our speed is really good, and I think we can speed up ridiculously quickly. I don't think there's any chance. And you know what? We can just go down this, because I make my own paths. Yeah. Yeah, motivational speech, 2016. Okay, let's check out this room. You got me. I'm interested. I'm less interested than when I first walked in the room, but I don't think it's bad. Yeah, Borderlands 2, forgot to install it, dumb. But hopefully it's a good game. I haven't played it yet, so I can't give you my assessment, but I've heard great things about it. I had it recommended by plenty of people, and you guys voted for it pretty much in mass. So, I mean, 50% is not like... I mean, I don't know what you... I don't know. Mass is a measure of weight. And you know what? I don't like to know my own right now because I've been eating like garbage lately. I think I ate fast food. Well, not necessarily fast food, but just... I wouldn't even call it unhealthy food, but food that I did not prepare myself. I ate like 3 times yesterday. I'm going to go ahead and just hermit now. Although maybe I shouldn't have done that. But we get the super greed fight, which means even more money. Our fortune grows further. And we'd really like to spend some soon. At least we're only on, what, Necropolis 1 here, which means we have a guaranteed no greed shop on the next floor. No, the sucky. Oh, the sucky. It's okay. He gives us crow's heart. Which honestly, I don't know what it does. It could be good, yes. It could be useless, yes. Both of which, crawl space, we finally got one. I don't know the percentage payout, by the way. Mom's perfume. Please stop. Mom's perfume, actually, look at this. Look at the -1 tears. I never realized that. Not only it's a tears upgrade, but it also can break the tears cap. It's one of the few items, I think there's only like 6 or so in the entire game, that actually breaks the tears cap of well, the typical one's 5, but you know. It can break that tier cap, which is awesome. I don't know that we have any benefit now of using shovel, because I think there can only be one crawl space on the entire floor. I could be wrong about that, of course. Okay, our range must have gone down or something, because I can't seem to kill those guys without getting hit. Mask of Infamy is annoying. Please, though, he's like sandwiched me like a... Ooh, Jimmy John's sounds so good. Oh, God, is that what we're getting for dinner, boys? I think it might be what we're getting for dinner. Let me know. Tell me your guys' favorite kind of like Sammy's. Guaranteed deal with the devil on this floor, thankfully. Let's see what it got. All right, the one thing I didn't want was a Krampus fight, especially when we're not getting... Oh my God, new Krampus attack is like if you got shot on your birthday. It's maybe the worst... I don't know what I'm trying to say. That's not a good metaphor. Open this new card. Hanged Man, you give me all these valueless cards. Valueless in the sense that I just have zero value on them. I think we'll just go ahead and leave this floor after we go in here. Attack 0.5 is fantastic. Okay, the Curse of the Maze is making me really want to leave ASAP. Oh my God, please. Is making me really want to leave. I will open those golden chests first. I'm excited. You can... Speaking of birthdays, you want to know a pill that's not invited to my next one? Not that I have birthday parties, I don't. It would be the I'm excited pill. Open that, open that. I mean, might as well drop these like they're hot. Nothing great out of them. We'll carry this battery charge down to the next floor. And speaking of the next floor, I think we're ready to go. This will help us pick up a little bit of time. No reason really to explore the entire floor. I mean, there could be other things out there. Curse the Blind basically can suck my left nut, to put it kindly. But it's not a huge deal. Have I just been, like, missing? I feel like when I play quickly, also someone pointed out, and I've pointed this out in the past, when I'm, like, trying to, not when I'm necessarily trying to play quickly, but when I just am playing quickly, like when we have a powerful run where I can move a little bit quicker, I also, like, speak ridiculously faster, like, at the speed of sound, basically. Okay, so we can finally actually get some sort of benefit from our shop. So that's pretty awesome. We should use this also, because that could happen. Pretty much exactly what you're looking for. Go on in here. Item, please. Actually, black market, please. Oh, we won't know what we're picking up, but I think I'm going to. Because we don't have a great chance of getting a deal with the devil anyway. Trinket Smelter, abso-freaking-lutely? Give me? Buy this as well? Converter, convert your soul? We could, like, convert HP. I am going to take pay to win, because I think pay to win puts a reroll machine in every item room, which is awesome. Now, getting rid of those red hearts has lowered our HP a little bit, or maybe it's reroll machines in every shop. I don't remember, but if you ask me, oh, goodbye, Curse of the Blind, you're gone forever. Rules card, sure. Okay, so we'll smelt this down. Okay, we don't get to use smelter a lot, so I think I'm actually going to roll with it. Maybe not for the entirety. Oh, baby. Oh, it's hard. Oh, you know what we can do? Hold on. Hold the flippin' phone for just a second. If you remember, we picked up this thing earlier that doubles all drops, and we got an Eternal Heart, which means two Eternal Hearts equals one full heart. And we can now do pay-to-play. No, we can now do more options and just pay a Red Heart for it instead of paying these Spirit Hearts, which is a really good trade, because if we do get reroll machines in the rooms like I'm thinking, we'll also take Swallowed Penny. Yeah, I think we'll just run with Smelter from here on out. It means we're not going to be able to take an item from Boss Rush, but all this, like, strategy stuff I just did over the last couple little bit has kind of slowed us down anyway, that I don't know that we're going to make it there in time. But we might. We might. You got to be kidding me with these sticky nickels. I'll do it, but I'm not happy about it. So yeah, after this we can smelt Swallowed Penny. The thing is though, like, how much value can you get out of Smelter, you know what I'm saying? Once you've smelted a certain number of trinkets, like, once you run out of trinkets, the item kind of just sits there. This would be an item that would be very good with the trinket, like, I don't know what it's called, but like full light bulb, if you know what I'm saying? Teleportation maybe? Another rules card? Dark Market lies under your feet. You lie under my feet. We missed Boss Rush, so might as well go for Guppy items. Didn't get any, of course. Are You a Wizard is not good. A health upgrade. What makes you small? I could be tempted into taking the health upgrade. But again, 30% deal with the devil chance. Not very good. Two health upgrades. Now I will take them. And we'll hold on to the second one. Open these up. Infamy is a good item. Again, the money's getting ridiculous. Make sure you save your keys so that you have enough. And we'll hold on to this other health upgrade. Okay, everyone is going to have a sticky nickel. Open that up. Cricket's head? No. Could have happened. Yeah, we missed Boss Rush. As long as we can make it to the Womb 2, or finish the Womb 2, by 30 minutes, we can still make the Hush fight. So, Boss Rush isn't the be-all, end-all, you know? It's not the thing. What makes you larger? After all I did to try to small myself? You're killing me, Smalls. You're more like you're killing my Smalls. Like, I was trying to get small, get it? All right, here's our shop. It cannot contain greed, which is maybe the best news I've heard all day. After the fact that, you know, I don't know, that I don't have lymphoma. I have no idea what I'm saying. Let's go in here. Let's see if we want to buy nothing. And you can see that there's no reroll machine in there, which means it must be reroll machines in every item room, which means we can basically make sure we get what we want. Moon card is pretty good. Let's find our item room, though. Oh my goodness, my neighbor's children have come home. I hope you're ready for the shouting. You make me want to shout. They don't make me want to shout. They're okay. We do get double items, but there's no reroll. We'll take Celtic Cross. So I don't know what pay to win does. Maybe it doesn't guarantee that there's going to be a reroll machine in there. It just increases the chances of it. I could see that as being what it actually does. Shovel, we're just going to bypass. I'll blow you up to try to get a higher deal with the Devil Chance. 8% higher. I mean, it's close to a coin flip, but if my luck is any indicator, it's probably not. I mean, probability also indicates we probably shouldn't get a deal with the Devil. But you know what? Probability never works in my favor. So maybe it'll work against my favor. You know what I'm saying? Like when we have like an 80% deal with the Devil chance and we don't get it, that means probability didn't work. I mean, it's still not going to work because why would it? But it's the thought that counts. Let's go. I'm regretting now taking the HP up pill. Though we should get a deal. We will guaranteed get a deal over the course of the next two floors or we'll die. So I don't really plan on option two happening. So just like be ready. If we could find another trinket to smelt, I would be okay with that. I'd be more than okay with it. I'd be through the freaking moon card. Hey-o. But yeah, that's the thing about probability is like, and I'm guilty of doing this, so I'm going to admit to it right now. What do we got here? One makes you larger, one makes you small, and a bad trip pill. I mean, we'll hold on to the bad trip, but not for long. I will admit that about myself, about probability. When the probability, like, that's one bad thing, I think I've said this before, about the stat tracker now, is I can see my deal with the devil chance. So when I have, like, a 78 deal with the devil chance, I'm like, what the heck, why didn't I get a deal with the devil? It's bull. However, because then at that point I tout like, oh, probability, it's probability states we should have gotten it, and then why did I'm so unlucky? But then at the same time we'll have like a 10% deal with the devil chance and we'll get it and I won't complain then. So if I was gonna be like, you know, equal across the board, I'm not taking cursed die. If I was gonna be equal across the board, I'd be like, oh, I didn't want this deal with the devil, the probability's not fair. Okay, we do get a reroll machine. I'll take hive mind. And the reroll machine is awesome because we can basically just keep getting new items in here until we get the items that we want. Yeah, Steam Sale for sure. We'll take Joker card is great. We'll take Battery Baby because why not? We'll reroll again. I don't value these items that much. Excuse me, I value restock quite a bit. I've taken a hit. That's okay though. We get another Joker card, so let's pop this Joker card. And of course, we're not going to be able to get rid of our HP because why would we? But the bright side is we can at least have a Joker card for the next floor. So we actually don't want to get a deal with the devil on this floor, funny enough. Let's pop this again. Blue candle's an interesting choice. I think we're pretty much past the usefulness of smelter. So now I'm going to reroll again. I'll just use a lot of my money here. Okay, I will use as much as I can and then it'll do that. Sharp plug? Eh, I don't think so. Okay, let's find our boss. I think we've gotten all the benefit out of this floor. This floor shop, I should say, that we can. We also want to be stacking up keys because when we go down to the hush fight, or maybe we won't have to. Maybe we'll get lucky like we did a couple runs ago and just get a void portal after the mom fight. It's a low probability chance, but probability seems to be the name of today's game. There is no exit here. I've gone the incorrect pathway, and I apologize for that. We're so tiny. Do I think we can beat the hush? The hush is pretty difficult with Azazel because you're so small. Oh my god, that was weird and glitchy and you know it. The hush is pretty obnoxious with Azazel because he's so... You have to get so close to him and he's just so bullet helly. But I still think we can... I still think we'll win. I would like a range upgrade though. If we could get Brimstone and that deal with the devil that we get when I pop the Joker card on the next floor. Like, that would be pretty fun, I think. I would be in the fan category. Not like an oscillating object that keeps you cool in the summer. I'm talking about like, you know, I support it. Oh, itchy nose, don't you sing to me. That's how it goes, right? What song was I trying to make a reference to there? It's bad when you make a reference and you don't even know what reference you're making. Also, we have blue candle, so I should be using it more because it's good. And that's also going to help us a ton on the hush fight because it kind of gives us a ranged option, if you will, as does Tech X. So we actually have way more ranged options than I was previously whining about. So basically ignore me. We're going to be fine and we're going to win. Although I do need to speed it up because this is only Scarred Womb 1 and I'm at 25 minutes because I've explored the entirety of the floor and gone every possible incorrect junction. Not that I'm bitter, but... if I had to describe myself in terms of, you know, a fruit flavor, I would probably say grapefruit. Because it's bitter? Oh my god, can I please get the right junction? I don't know if junction's the right word, but I'm gonna keep using it as if it is. I'm not even gonna pick up the sacks, because we're in trouble. Oh, please. We're kind of in trouble, like, if we don't speed it up. I always, like, laugh about how fast we get to go as Azazel. And then in this one instance, it's... Really, though? Please stop taking damage? And I thought I killed you? We are done here. No deal with the devil. No deal with the devil. No deal with the devil. The one time. Belly button is double trinket. We can come back as the lost. We could maybe get a lost victory at the end of this. That'd be funny. Let's get it. So we'll hold on to the Joker card because we could still, at the end of the floor, get the 33% deal with the devil chance. It is completely in the realm of possibilities. I'm just going to slide past you guys if I could. It's completely in the realm of possibilities, and then we could get a deal with the devil on the next floor. We've gotten one Guppy item. Let's get a second one right here. Or get teleported and then get Incubus. Are you going to shoot? Oh my god, you got short Brimstone. Well, that doesn't really help us. But at least we can hold the Joker card to the next floor. I'm on a freaking very tight schedule right now, if you do not understand. Oh, please. And so we need to hurry. I'm also, like, hemorrhaging HP faster than I maybe would have imagined that we were going to. And that's bad. Come on, guys. Come on now. There you go. Keep it coming. Where are you at? Nice. One more. I see you. Invisobill. There we go. Perfect. Are we done? Alges. Alges is very good and could save our life. So the question is, do I value the deal with the devil? And I value Alges more, I'll be honest. I think it's going to be... It's the smarter play. The more daring play would be using the Joker card, getting like freaking, you know, getting freaking, you know, regular Brimstone or something, and then being like, boosh, we win. But... When I'm like playing for fun, I would do the more cutesy play like that. When we're playing to try to finish off the post note, I think it's in your best interest to go with what makes logical sense. And what makes logical sense is remembering that there's a tinted rock right here that you walked right by. Not that it's going to give you spirit hearts anyway, but what do we got in here? Got a hanged man. This thing really likes hanged man cards. This is also a great room for tinted rocks, but I don't see one. Okay, we got the shop here and we didn't get a reroll machine, but we can buy infinite spirit hearts. So... That's all that matters. Get to full HP, and now you're pretty much as ready as you can be. You could be what you wanna be. Do you guys remember, that's a Blue's Clues song, first of all. Or is it Barney? I think that was, thanks for doing your part. That's definitely Blue's Clues, gotta be. Did you guys ever do like in your early education, elementary school education, do you guys ever have like those like, what do you call them? Like, I guess they're like not musicals per se, but it's like little kids. You just get together and sing. I don't know why, but we did one of those when I was a kid that we had to like sing about occupations. And for some reason, to this day, literally we did it in second grade. And to this day, I can like recite to you the entire song. I wanna be an architect, manager, therapist, accountant, vocalist, astronaut, principal, nurse, school teacher. Oh, I forgot the rest. I'm sorry. Maybe I can't recite it all. Of course, we get the 33% deal with the devil. Okay, come down to Hush Fight. I'll just ruin it up. And, oh god, I'm gonna sneeze. Oh god, I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, please don't. Oh, please. Oh god. Oh god. Oh. I have never felt this much pain in my entire life. I didn't sneeze. Oh my god, there's like a pain in my chest. Yes, quad shot. Our tier, oh god, plus 41. That's kind of unfortunate. Double baby all the way across the sky, I think so. King baby, don't know what it does. Okay, hold your familiars in place. That prompts me, then they go. When you're shooting, they hold in place. When you let go, the king baby moves and they follow the king baby. Okay, I see it. Let's donate some because we can. Ooh. Ooh. All right. Broken donation machine. The question is now, do you take the sack dagger for both defense and... I think you do, because Spoonbender doesn't work. The only way we get Spoonbender to work is if we pick up, like, a Joker card in one of these, which did not happen, is if we pick up a Joker card in one of these and... And yeah. But we didn't make it happen. So, what do I value more? The box of friends gives us two orbitals on the boss fight. And if the battery babies give us more than we can get. Yeah, I definitely value this more. We have the money, so we might as well buy stuff. I don't even know what compost does. It gives me a spider, apparently. Broken stopwatch, I don't really value with stopwatch. But I also wouldn't want to buy the freaking pills because it would get rid of Alger's Rune. Let's just go ahead and do this. Let's fight Hush. We're doing a lot of damage. The double incubuses are going to be nice. Unfortunately, King Baby's going to, like, kind of hold them back. But it's going to be nice when they, like... So we can, like, almost, like, run here and then, like, hold them there. Yeah. And then unleash with them. Unleash with them. But then also part of me thinks that's getting a little bit too cutesy with things. I don't know why I keep saying cutesy, but I feel like I'm getting a little too cutesy with things. So maybe it's a better strategy to just actually just fire. Okay. We're doing a lot of damage. The hope is that Battery Baby. Also, we're going to be getting invincibility every now and again. Not only thanks to Polaroid, but also thanks to Celtic Cross. And remember, we can pop our Alge's Rune, but I'd rather pop that on the Delirium fight. Popping that on the Delirium fight is pretty much a guaranteed win. Get down here, guys. Yeah, and he's going to come right on top of you, and you're going to blast him. And you're going to blast him, except that I held the button not long enough. Blast him. There you go. There you go. Get over here. And then you're going to blast him. Again, it's kind of weird with the King Baby. I'm not a huge fan of it, honestly, but I could see it being good in some situations. But pretty much no situations do I see it actually being good. Oh, not to mention we have the stopwatch. That makes this fight a heck of a lot easier. Although there is a lot of bullets on the screen. I would not deny you if you said that. I would agree with you. Hopefully we can block these. Oh, they won't even reach us because we're the greatest. Okay, he's going to come up. Every time he comes up. And every time he comes, I get this feeling. Okay, maybe not the greatest song of all time. But, you know, a decent, you know, pornographic parody, I would say. Okay, we do get a battery, so why not pop another one, and then another one, you know what I'm saying? And then get a full suite of these, lovely daggers. Okay, but we can't dodge that, and it's also not slow, so it's kind of stupid. But we got, I mean, there's no issue. I hope that's fairly obvious. Now, let's hope and pray that with these familiars, they don't make it impossible for me to go down to the void. You've done it again. You've done it again. I hate you so much, game. I literally despise this game. And everything it freaking stands for. Oh, the game had an update recently, and they did this really cool thing where the Big Horn no longer has boss armor. It's fantastic. You don't have to worry about his ridiculous damage resistance. Oh, that's cool. Any other change they made? Yeah, you can't go to the alternate path. It just doesn't work anymore. We put the portal there, but it's mostly just like a little, you know, a couple yanks on your dingling, and then, oh, sorry. You wanted to finish this run? Sorry. We're blue balling you again. Sorry for the vulgarity, but I'm a little upset. I'm a little upset. You know what? I'm going to the Reddit. I'm going to the Reddit right now. We're going to see if anybody else is complaining about this, because I promise they are. Binding of Isaac. Oh my god, caps lock is on. Isaac Reddit. I might even contribute to a post. I'll be like, I'm recording an episode right now, and this is bull. Okay, Afterbirth update, unofficial patch notes. Let's read them. Big Horn no longer has damage scaling armor. Okay, cool. Fix the bug with Ludovico technique. Okay, Satanic Bible, Deadeye. Okay, fix the bug where you save Quinn in the middle of a challenge room. Okay, Delirium fight. Gate would always spawn outside the room. Game. Fix when storing and deleting the game state. Okay. Changes in Big Horn's AI. Changes in Robo Baby. Blah, blah, blah. Portal. Portal. Anything about the portal? Resources. Ragman has been nerfed. He only has 200 HP instead of 250. That's pretty cool. Okay, what else? Tell me about this portal. I'm glad Ragman got the HP nerf. Okay. Really? Nobody's complaining about this? What? What? Nobody's complaining about this. Tell me. Okay, well... It's useless. I don't think we're going to be able to go in. Yeah. We could try everything that we tried before. Oh, you know what I can do? King baby, hold them. Hold the familiars away. There's no familiars on me! I have no familiars. Someone told me it was a familiar thing. Maybe it's a bomb thing? Maybe it's a bomb thing? Please tell me. Please tell me. Please tell me what to do. If you guys know what the deal is with this, hopefully it's fixed by the time this episode actually comes out. But assuming it's not, let me know why my life sucks. And tell me if I should stick a letter opener in my skull. I haven't decided yet. But I'm leaning yes. If you just like stayed on it for a long time, will it eventually suck you down? I don't know. Toilet bowl style? Come on, man. It's like when you got that... You got that large loaf and it just, that's disgusting. Shut your mouth. Okay, well, I'm just going. Oh, one try. One more try. You got me. You caught me. I will do it. I will go down. I will press space bar and go down. Okay, well, we're going up. Oh, the hope now, again, as we had last time, is that the game is kind to us and basically gifts us a portal, which is statistically improbable, but it could happen. And that's our only hope at getting this done now at this point. So thank you, game, for once again hurting my feelings in every way, shape, and or form. I feel really bad about myself, so hope you're happy. And hopefully we can just make the rest of this episode go relatively quickly because there's literally no point in doing anything anymore. Give me Guppy's head. You couldn't even gift me something after the pain you've put me through. I don't even care. Blow me up. Blow me up. I want you to do it. Hit me. I want you to do it. I want you to do it. Hit me. Hit me! Yeah, he actually did it. I was kidding. I was quoting The Dark Knight, one of the greatest movies of all time. But you did that instead. Cool! Isaac, fight time. Let's just blow him away, basically. I've been hit. That's okay. We'll blow him away on the next one. We got that Celtic Cross invincibility. Void portal. Do me dirty. You have not done me dirty. This is the cleanest you've ever done me. That's okay, though. We could still get one at the end of this floor. We could also pick up Dad's key and increase our chances further. 9-volt, I mean, electric Jacob's ladder, tears, cool. Camo underwear, sure, why not? Come on, you cannot do this to me. I'm not gonna, like, try. Remember we could have won as the keeper and then we freaking didn't get a portal? Kind of be mad about that. Perthro, give me Dad's key. All right, Demon Babby. Sure, I'll take Demon Babby. Other than that, though, let's just get it. I dropped my allergies room. Oh, you got less health, buddy. I just read some notes about you. Oh, I just read some notes. See you later. I don't even care how many chests drop. Although they could contain Dad's key, so I should care about how many chests drop. And therefore, I will still do everything in my power. I will explore every room, get every chest to drop. You know, get every... I mean, let's be honest, it's me, so I'm gonna have to explore every room anyway to find the actual ending room. But I will explore every room and look for Dad's key. And I will leave as many reroll targets available as possible so that if we get more Perthro runes in the future, we could maybe reroll them and get Dad's key. And then my thought here is, you know, if we don't get... And these are all going to contain Perthro runes, so... main thought here, of course, is that... It'd be cool if we get Yara and Perthros, but, you know, I can't ask for too much. The main thought is if our blue baby fight does not pay out... with a void portal, we could maybe get Dad's key, then beat Mega Satan, and then maybe get one there, but, obviously that's, you're grasping for straws, I don't know what the correct terminology is there, it's unlikely. 9 lives is pretty cool, though. Oh, that's also pretty good. I will take both of these, even though I said I would reroll, because, oh, Tag X just doesn't work, that's fun. Yeah, thanks, cool. Awesome synergies, guys. One of my favorites. Cool, just end this guy's life because I can't stand this anymore. Let's go ahead and fight Blue Baby. Let's see what we got here. Stars card, not that useful. Blue Baby, you're going to get torched pretty quickly. I don't even care how much damage we take because we're not going to lose. And this void portal, you've done it. You've done it, and for that, I thank you so much. You're my favorite. All right, I didn't bring the Alge's rune. Okay, so be a little more careful, because it's not one yet. A Chariot card is kind of just like a really bad Alge's Rune if you think about it. Oh no. The Alge's Rune was essentially a guaranteed win, and I goofed. But maybe another one will make itself. Are you kidding me with the fuse on that bomb? Sorry for going voice so high that it's like I'm in seventh grade again, but golly! That bomb had a very long fuse. Let's stop losing all our HP. Infamy! I'm taking damage that no human being that has played The Binding of Isaac for the amount of time that I have should ever take. We need HP so badly if we're gonna win this. Please. Oh, it's a freaking emperor. I'm gonna use it, not delirium. You wouldn't, okay. He didn't. Okay, so we're going to do this. We actually should have, that was stupid of me. We should have held on to the emperor card because then if we ever got to a boss fight, what? It ended, okay. If we ever got to a boss fight that was, nice, please. Not Small Rock. For the first time in my life, I'm gonna ask not Small Rock. If we ever get to a boss fight that's delirium and we're not ready or not confident enough to fight it, we could have Emperor carded out. So like if this ends up being delirium and we lose because of it, I'll be very upset, Emperor. You've done me dirty. It is delirium. See you later, sucker. That would have been really funny if that would just teleport me right back to the same boss fight with delirium in it. Okay, but we now know which room delirium's in, which is good. He's in that top left corner up there. So let's find some tinted rocks, my friends. Let's get some HP back. Let's win this freaking run with Azazel, which should have been quite simple, but I'm making it more difficult than maybe it needs to be. To a spades, give me all them keys. Yeah, I'm totally fine with that. Too close. Too close there. Another Emperor card, which there's no reason to use. But I would like to go find that Perthro rune that we were holding on to earlier. And go reroll Mr. Boom. Because Mr. Boom is not an item that I'm really that interested in. Honestly, with the amount of invincibility frames that we could get from, like, between, you know, Polaroid and also Celtic Cross, I think we could win this one. But why have any doubt? You should do all the other boss fights, maybe get something amazing like the wafer. I'll also be very upset if we end up getting a Guppy item, and I could have transformed into Guppy if I would have taken 9 lives. Although it would have ruined Polaroid invincibility, so I still maintain that that was the best move to not do that. Look, two little tiny guys right next to each other. Oh my god, it's like a, I don't know what I'm trying to say. It's like a tiny person parade. I don't know. That doesn't mean anything. Those are just words. Those are just adjectives for what I'm seeing in front of me. You piece of garbage! Because we could have taken 9 lives and then Guppy's pawed down and gotten more HP from it. And then we'd be Guppy. So now I have to become Guppy. I have to find a golden chest that contains Guppy's head. I must find a golden chest that contains Guppy's head. If I don't, I will officially have brought in dishonor upon my family. We should actually take Star's card because that won't teleport us to a boss fight. We're never going to need to teleport again. Devil card. Devil card helps us. We can get that Alja's rune back. God, we had a guaranteed win between Guppy and the Alja's rune, but my own anger has led to my downfall. Isn't that how the most great people of nobility go down in their lifetimes? Not saying I'm a freaking king or anything, because I'm not, but, you know, maybe someday. Please end his life, thank you. Where's the last one? Hello? Oh god, he's so tiny! Guppy's head. Head of Guppy. Head of Guppy. I will open all of your chests, but you have no head of Guppy. But I think we can still do it. I think we can still become Guppy. If we become Guppy, I would say this one is, as close to... What? Was there Invisible Man? Guppy, Guppy. He's done it. Okay, still low on HP, yes. But with a new lease on life and with a Guppy transformation with Hive Mind, we are gonna be doing some damage real quick and now we can do this and get our HP back up. Look at all the battery charges, friends. There actually aren't that many battery charges, but let's go get them. Let's go pick up some battery charges that we've unlocked on the floor already. There should be some around, or not. We just haven't been dropping battery charges. I find that pretty unlikely. Where are they hiding at? Okay, there's some over here. So we'll get the ones that are over here. And then we will get a couple more HP. Where are you at, though? I saw one in this room. Maybe not. Maybe I didn't see one in this room. Please stop with the scary screen, though. The spooky screen, I'm not a fan of. Pick up this battery charge. And we'll pick up that one last battery charge. And I think we'll just go fight Delirium, because at this point, it should be a sealed deal. I went into the wrong room. Luckily, we're not going to have to pay for it. But Mexico is, you know what I'm saying? We should pick up Devil Card. Devil Card, I think, is most valuable for us. And let's pick this up as well. Maybe get another battery charge. Nope. Have I just not been opening the sacks? And that's the issue. Maybe I should learn how to read a goddamn map. That would be a helpful skill, I think, in life. Okay. Devil Card. We will pick back up our doubling of friends. And then this one, I mean, I'm making this up more than it needs to be. I don't know why I'm min-maxing this so much. Oh, I definitely thought I went to a room I wasn't supposed to. Let's fight a boss just to get a good feeling about our lives. We'll pop this here. I think it does nothing. Yeah. Useless. And then we'll just go ahead and fight Delirium, who we know is this bottom left one here. Also, whoever said that Delirium doesn't spawn next to other enemies, just like completely lying. I mean, not lying, but maybe just misinformed. I don't know. Yeah, you see like the damage. We got a pretty good chance this one. Plus the Elder's Rune is now going to pop in and Big Horn. You're dunzo funzo, basically. We're more than halfway done. We can double our friends again. And that sounds fun to me. I love having friends. I have a need for Tweed. Much like Creed. You know what I'm saying? There's two of you. And that's bull. I don't know. My charge time is actually infinite. And so I'm not actually shooting anything. But there we go. That should end it. All right. Well, I was kidding. That should end it. And that's going to be another win. Look at the sweat. I don't know what to do anymore because I don't even want to do void runs if we're just banking on the fact that that a portal opens up. Like, the stress is not good on my young heart. 52 minutes? Really? I'm so slow. Dark Prince's crown has appeared in the basement. Thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy, make sure you subscribe to become a citizen of Playcraft Nation today. And if you know anybody that you think would be a great podcast center, go ahead and send them a like, because we'd love to have them. But with that, I'm going to go check and make sure my brain is still functioning, and I will see you guys next time.